Imagine that I'm Treasurer Joe Hockey, and Joe Hockey's a DJ. DJ Sloppy Joe on the wheels of steel of the Australian economy. On one deck, you've got the free market. On the other, this guy's tax legislation. But right here, this fader, this operates negative gearing. This is the fader the whole dance floor wants DJ Sloppy Joe to tweak, but he won't. He won't drop the bass, and everyone on the dance floor under 40 can't afford a house. Meanwhile, club owners are making millions in overpriced drinks. And that's about as sexy as I can make a story on negative gearing.
Negative gearing is when the interest you're paying on a home loan is more than the income it generates. So if you bought a $440,000 property, taking out a $400,000 loan at an interest rate of 7%, you'd pay 28 grand a year in interest. But you pull $430 a week renting it out, that's $22,360 a year, leaving you $5,640 short. That is a claimable loss, which you can use to reduce your overall tax payable on your salary. So, who benefits from negative gearing?
The typical kind of group is middle-aged people, particularly self-employed and professionals who use the deficits on their rental properties to shelter other sources of income.
This is the second time the RBA has highlighted concern over soaring house prices.
I'm very concerned about Sydney. I think some of what's happening is crazy.
The case against negative gearing is that it largely pushes up house prices. It therefore makes it more difficult for first home buyers.
For his part, Joe Hockey hasn't moved on too far from his stance on home ownership.
The starting point for a first home buyer is to get a good job that pays good money.
Now the RBA is arguing that negative gearing is encouraging debt-fueled property speculation.
Negative gearing plays a part. It's not the only cause, but it is an important factor, I believe, in the growing volatility in housing markets.
Some argue that negative gearing plays a valuable role for middle Australians. 73% of people who utilise negative gearing just invest in one property. Others say that the tax benefits only privilege the rich. The Australia Institute says $4.2 billion in tax breaks like this go to the top 10% of income earners. Meanwhile, the opposition is providing no alternative.
I'm not making detailed policy announcements today on capital gains or negative gearing.
Well, with tax reforms, there are always losers. And because there are losers, I guess politicians are reluctant to stick their necks out.
Meanwhile, back here in the club, everybody's still waiting for DJ Sloppy Joe to drop that negative gearing bass. So long, they've actually gone home. If they had one.